Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Aranas and I will be your teacher today. Today's discussion is all about factoring by grouping, tips in grouping terms, and steps in factoring by grouping. So first, let us know when can we use factoring by grouping. Factoring by grouping method can be used in finding the factors of a polynomial expression that has four or more terms. It is very hard to find the factors of a polynomial expression that has four or more terms. But I will give you some tips in grouping terms so that you can get the correct and exact factor. In grouping terms, it could be a binomial and a binomial, or a binomial and a trinomial. But take note, make sure that each of the group has anything in common which is called the greatest common factor or the GCF. Since we already know how to group terms, now it is the time to know further about the steps in factoring by grouping. So the first step in factoring by grouping is to create smaller groups within the expression. So in this step, you need to decide which term can be grouped together that has something in common with the other. So the second step is to factor out the GCF from each of the two groups. In finding the GCF of this step, is you need to factor out each expression so that you can get a common factor with the other. So the third step is to write the expression as a product of the GCF and the remaining factor. Since we already know how to group terms and steps in factoring by grouping, now it is the time to apply those learning to this example. So the first example, we have 4x minus xy plus 20 minus 5y. So what do you think are the factors of this expression? So the step one in factoring by grouping is to create smaller groups within the expression. So let us think which term can be grouped together. So as we can see, the first and second term have a common variable, which is x. So we can group them together. As we can observe also in the third and fourth variable, they are both divisible by 5, so we can group them together. So the second step in factoring by grouping is to factor out the GCF from each of the two groups. In the first group, we have 4x minus xy. Since they have both x variable, then we can factor out x and it will become x times 4 minus y. And the second group, we have 20 minus 5y. Since they are both divisible by 5, then we can factor out 5 and it will become 5 times 4 minus y. As we can see, 4 minus y appears in the two groups. This means that 4 minus y is the GCF of this expression. So the step 3 in factoring by grouping is to write the expression as a product of the GCF and the remaining factor. So the GCF is 4 minus y, and the remaining factor is x plus 5. Therefore, the factors of 4x minus xy plus 20 minus 5y are 4 minus y and x plus 5. The second example, we have 2a squared c plus 3a squared b minus 10b squared c minus 15b squared d. So what do you think are the factors of this expression? So the step one in factoring by grouping is to create a smaller group within the expression. So what do you think are the terms can be grouped together? So as we can see, the first and second term have a common variable, which is a squared, then we can group them. So we have a squared c plus 3a squared d. So the third and fourth term, as we can observe, they are both divisible by 5 and have a common variable, which is b squared. So we can group them as well. So we have 10b squared c minus 15b squared d. So the step 2 in factoring by grouping is to factor out the GCF from each of the two groups. So in the first group, we have 2a squared c plus 3a squared d. We can factor out a squared, so it will become a squared times 2c plus 3d. In the second term, since they are both divisible by 10 and have a common variable, which is b, then we can factor out 5b squared and it will become c, and it will become 2c plus 3d. The step 3 is to write the expression as a product of the GCF and the other factor. So the GCF is 2c plus 3d. So 2c plus 3d. And the remaining terms, which is a squared minus 5b squared. So therefore, the factor of 2a squared c plus 3a squared d minus 10b squared c minus 15b squared d are 2c plus 3d and a squared minus b squared. The fourth example, we have 3x squared minus 4xy plus y squared minus 3x plus 1. So as we can see, there are 5 terms in this expression. So let us recall on how to group terms in a given expression. So in grouping terms, it could be a binomial and a binomial, or a trinomial and a binomial. So we could have a one binomial group and one trinomial group. So in step 1, we can group the first, second, third group term because they can be simplified further. So we have 3x squared minus 4xy plus y squared. So the fourth and fifth term can be grouped together. So we have 3x plus y. So the second step in factoring by grouping is to factor out the GCF from each of the two groups. So the factor of this expression are 3x minus y and x minus 1. So in this group, we can factor out negative 1 and it will become negative 1 times 3x minus 1. So the third step in factoring by grouping is to write the expression as a product of the GCF and the other factor. So we have 3x minus y is the GCF, and the remaining factor is x minus y minus 1. Therefore, the factor of 3x squared minus 4xy plus y squared minus 3x plus y are 3x minus y and x minus y minus 1. Thank you for listening, and for further knowledge, you just click the link below and try to answer the following activity. Thank you.